can read all you want.
That's right.
I'm asking you the same question.
Understand.
Do you understand what you read?
Amen.
All right, next letter. Come on.
All right, this letter says, Pastor Jennings, for some time now I've been watching your Sunday night program.
All right.
I do enjoy watching you, Pastor Jennings. Indeed, I enjoy listening to you as well, learning the Bible and learning the Bible from you. My only concern is that you did preach some weeks ago that we should not read the Bible. Surely people like you are inspired by God to interpret the Bible, but I don't know why you preach that it's wrong to read the Bible. I thought it was written that we must search the Scriptures. How do you search the Scriptures if we don't read the Bible? Must the truth come only from my pastor? Thank you for your understanding.
First and foremost, you probably misunderstand me. I've never preached don't read the Bible.
No.
Because the Bible says give attentive to
reading.
But we believe in putting things in the right order.
Right.
Reading is good. But the Bible says this, in all thine getting,
get understanding.
Get a understanding.
That's right.
So what I did say is this, you can read all you want, but reading don't help you if you don't understand.
That's right.
Let me show you this in the Bible.
In Acts chapter 8.
Now we're going to read the Bible.
That's right.
We're going to read it.
That's right. Amen.
Listen at this.
Acts chapter 8 and at verse 30.
We don't stop nobody from reading. You can read all you want.
Yeah.
But if you don't understand what you're reading, you ain't helping yourself none.
That's right.
Come on, son.
Acts chapter 8 and at verse 30.
Listen.
And Philip ran thither to him.
Now here you had Philip the evangelist.
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
And there was a eunuch from Ethiopia.
Right.
Yeah. In charge of the queen's treasure.
That's right.
Candace.
That's right.
And this official, this treasurer,
amen,
was reading.
And sitting in his chariot, read Isaiah the prophet.
He was doing what billions are doing today.
That's right.
Listen.
Was returning and sitting in his chariot, read Isaiah the prophet.
He read Isaiah the prophet.
Then the Spirit said unto Philip.
Then the Spirit said to Philip.
Go near and join thyself to this chariot.
Philip, somebody's doing something.
That's right. That's right.
God, they doing something.
That's right.
They don't know what to do. And they're not going to know what to do afterward.
Amen.
You better draw yourself nigh to them.
And Philip ran thither to him.
What?
Philip ran thither to him.
Wow, Philip knew. Glory to God. They're reading something. And they're reading the thoughts of God.
That's right.
And God don't want them to be misled.
That's right.
And he had to run to him.
That's right.
But notice who told him to run.
The Spirit said unto Philip.
The Spirit.
That's right.
The Bible says the body without the spirit is dead.
Amen.
Before you go running to somebody trying to explain the scriptures, be sure you spiritually inclined first.
That's right.
If you're not spiritually inclined first, don't you try to interpret what you don't understand.
That's right.
Even if you're a preacher, don't try to dabble in a subject you can't understand.
That's right.
Submit yourself to teaching.
Amen.
Excellent.
Go ahead, brother. Go ahead.
God, if you don't understand, submit yourself and be taught.
That's right.
Amen.
That's right.
Why get up and try to deal with the subject to look prestigious?
Amen.
And then the only thing that come out of your mouth is folly.
That's right.
And ignorance.
That's right.
If you don't know, tell the fool, I don't know.
I don't know.
I'll get back to you.
That's right.
That's right. There ain't no shame.
Amen. Amen.
My God, when the king came to Daniel and told him his dream,
right,
it is written how Daniel was puzzled.
That's right.
For 1 hour.
That's true.
Didn't know the answer.
Didn't answer him immediately.
That's right.
He didn't know it.
That's right.
He had to wait. Thank God in the book of Zechariah, when the two olive trees appeared to Zechariah, the angel asked,
what are these?
You know what are these?
What are these?
He told him, I don't know.
That's right.
That's right. Prophet.
He was a prophet. But I don't know.
That's right.
That's true.
It had to be revealed to him.
That's right.
Wonderful.
Don't be hasty to utter anything before the Lord.
That's right.
Even Zechariah asked the angel, what are?
What are these?
These two olive trees. What are these?
That's right.
Glory to God.
Amen.
Come on, son.
And Philip ran thither to him.
He ran thither to them.
And heard him read the prophet Isaiah.
He heard him reading something here.
And said, understandest thou what thou readest?
That's all I'm saying.
That's it.
You can read all you want.
That's right.
I'm asking you the same question.
Understandest
thou what thou readest? Do you understand what you read?
That's it. And he said,
Now, what did the eunuch say?
How can I except some man should guide
me? That's all I'm saying.
That's right.
Got to hear a man.
Got to have a preacher that guides you.
That's right. That's right.
Yeah.
Amen. Gotta have an anointed God taught, God made, God called, God given preacher.
Amen.
Who know how to navigate through the scriptures.
Yes, that's right.
Huh?
That's right.
How to navigate through the Bible.
Amen.
Don't need no help from theology.
No.
He don't pre-plan no message.
Oh no.
Jesus told him, don't premeditate.
Don't premeditate.
At the same hour.
Amen.
It'll be given to you what to say.
That's right.
In fact, Jesus said, don't even give it thought.
That's right.
Don't take no thought.
No thought.
What was he teaching his preachers? Rely on me.
That's right.
You're an apostle. You're writing out a sermon. No. You're not an apostle.
No.
Mm-mm, you're not an apostle.
Oh no.
Oh no, you're not an apostle.
No way.
God told his apostles, take no thought.
No thought.
And he also said, take no script.
No script. That's
so
right.
Why are you writing a sermon?
Amen.
And putting a text on it.
That's right.
You're not an apostle.
Oh,
when
no.
You're an apostle, you never plan.
That's right.
When you're an apostle, God gives you what the people need all the time.
All the time.
Amen.
Go ahead.
Hallelujah. Hallelujah.
Go ahead.
Wonderful, sir.
Go ahead,
brother. Hallelujah.
When you find yourself planning,
go ahead, brother.
And preparing a message just one time, you're not an apostle.
That's right.
No, 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 no. God teaches his apostle.
That's right.
And let him know what the people got to have.
Amen. Amen.
He don't worry about getting theology degrees.
No.
He'll be like Peter and John.
Mm-hmm.
When they perceived that they was ignorant, unlearned man, they marvel.
That's right.
That they've been with Jesus.
That's it.
I never took a Bible course since I've been born.
Wonderful.
But I've been with Jesus.
That's right.
I've been with him then.
That's right.
And I'm with him now.
Go ahead.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
Glory to God.
Go ahead.
Wonderful talk.
And I'm determined to stay with him.
That's right.
All I know.
Go ahead.
I got it from God.
Amen.
Amen. Wonderful.
All I credit all my knowledge to God.
To God. That's right.
Hallelujah. I credit all my revelation.
That's right.
To God.
Amen.
I credit my God-given ability.
Yes.
To split the atom of the scriptures.
Go ahead,
and show you how the molecules work in there.
Go ahead.
I credit God.
That's it.
Don't have no degrees at all.
At all.
Never been to seminary school in my life.
That's right.
My God, if I enrolled in a seminary school, we'll turn that stuff upside down.
That's right.
Oh, yeah.
Why? Right. Because you can't be of God and be in seminary school and hear lies and be comfortable.
No way.
You'll be like Paul when he went down to Athens.
That's right.
Among Greece.
That's right.
The Bible said his spirit was stirred.
Stirred up in
him. Hallelujah.
That's it.
Hallelujah.
Go ahead.
That's right.
Amen.
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah. Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah. Hallelujah.
Was
amen.
Go ahead.
Yes, sir.
Go ahead, brother.
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
Glory to God. When you're a man of God,
hallelujah.
You expose the lies.
Hallelujah.
It arouse your spirit.
Hallelujah.
You got the crown.
That's right.
You got the crown.
Hallelujah.
Glory to God.
Amen.
Got to do it.
Hallelujah. Yes, sir.
Anytime you claim you're a man of God,
yes.
And you bargain,
yes.
And shut your mouth,
yes.
Just to go along with,
he's
a false prophet and a deceiver.
That's right.
Amen.
That's right.
The Holy Ghost in you,
yes.
Makes you uncomfortable.
That's right.
You can't rest.
No, no.
Spirit is stirred.
Stirred up.
Wonderful.
That's right.
Wonderful.
When the apostles were thrown in prison, the angel of the Lord came in freedom and told them, go in the temple.
That's right.
And tell the people all the words of this life.
Amen.
This is after the government of that time told them, did we not command you?
That's right.
Not to preach in that name.
That name. Go ahead.
When you got the thing in you, you can't help yourself.
That's right.
That's what Jesus was talking.
That's
when
right.
He said it's like rivers.
That's right.
Hurry
living
up.
Go ahead.
Lower to God.
Go ahead.
Living water.
Go ahead.
Stuff gotta spring up.
That's right.
Gotta spring up.
That's
in
right.
You.
That's right.
And overflow.
Hallelujah. Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
Glory to God.
Hallelujah. Hallelujah.
What did he say, son?
Understandest thou what thou
readest? That's all I'm saying.
Amen.
It's nothing wrong with reading the Bible.
No.
But you better be able to understand
what thou read.
What you read.
And he said,
and if you don't understand what you read,
how can
then
I?
Reading is no good.
That's right.
And he asked him, do you understand what you read?
Amen.
And the eunuch said, how can I accept a man guide me?
God,
you got to have a man that give you a guided tour.
That's
from
right.
Genesis to Revelation.
That's
why?
Right.
Because all scriptures are given by the inspiration of God.
That's
so
right.
The same God that inspired a book got to get a man to guide you through the book.
That's
so
right.
He can get you to God.
Then Amen. Philip opened his mouth.
Then Philip opened his mouth.
And began at the same scripture.
And did what?
And preached unto him Jesus.
Holy.
Go ahead.
Old Testament.
Hallelujah.
Old
Testament. He preached Jesus.
Jesus.
And there was no New Testament.
No, it wasn't.
Huh?
That's right.
There was no New Testament.
That's right.
You from the Old Testament.
That's right.
There was no New Testament.
No, it wasn't.
That's it.
None.
None.
He was reading from the book of Isaiah.
That's right.
And Philip went right in there.
At the same scripture.
And at the same scripture.
And preached unto him Jesus.
He went to Isaiah.
Go ahead.
And preached Jesus.
Jesus.
Why? Philip knew who was the prophet talking about.
That's right.
You understand?
That's right.
There was no New Testament then.
No, it wasn't.
That let you know Jesus was here before he was born.
That's right.
That's right. Go ahead.
Jesus was here.
Hallelujah.
Before.
That's right.
He was born.
That's right.
Who you talking about? The inner man.
That's right.
That made the world. He made the outer man. They ain't got in him. Then the outer man took on his name.
Hallelujah.
And took on his title.
Go ahead.
That's it. Wonderful, sir.
It's good.
When you preach Jesus Christ as God,
go ahead,
and you start that teaching off at Mary's carrying a baby, you don't know what you're talking.
That's right.
God was here.
That's right.
Before Mary was born.
Amen.
Everlasting, sir.
It's good teaching.
God never was 12.
No.
God never was 30.
That's right.
Do you know Christ was in the wilderness?
That's right.
That rock.
That's right.
That throttled him.
That was Christ.
That was Christ.
That's right.
Amen.
Go ahead, brother.
But it wasn't no flesh and blood.
That's no.
It was no man.
No.
It was the spirit of the living God.
That's right.
Amen.
That's right.
Excellent.
And when the spirit stopped that David house.
Go ahead, brother.
And made a man child.
Go ahead.
God had a dirty job.
Yes,
he couldn't do it the way he was.
That's right.
Because it took blood to be shed.
That's right.
God had no blood.
Go ahead.
Because the nature of God is perpetual.
Go ahead.
The nature of God is eternal.
That's right.
The nature of God is everlasting.
That's right.
The nature of God is spirit.
That's right.
So spirit made a child.
Yes.
Got in the child.
That's right.
And took him on.
That's right.
And
go ahead.
Hiding himself.
Go ahead. Go ahead. Go ahead.
Then the child grew.
That's right.
God did not grow.
That's right.
The child grew. The
child grew.
In wisdom and in knowledge.
That's right.
God don't grow in wisdom.
No.
God is wisdom.
That's right.
God don't grow in knowledge.
No.
God is knowledge.
Go ahead.
God have all understanding.
Go ahead.
Amen.
That's good preaching, man.
There's a separation.
That's right.
Between the nature of the Son of Man and the nature of God.
That's right.
Wonderful, boss.
Mary ain't never been Godmother.
No.
And never will.
That's right.
So yeah, reading is good.
Reading's good.
That's right.
Understanding what you read is better.
That's
because
right.
Because then and only then you can obey it.
That's right.
All right, Dan, the man. Come on, son. All right.